For this lesson, we will focus on the Art Renderer. Autodesk Ray Trace, or Art Renderer, is an unbiased renderer, which means it has fewer controls, but it renders photorealistically. Open the scene file, rendering C start.max. It's the train station scene file we've been using throughout these lessons. There is already a physical camera viewport, but without any lights. Go to the Render Setup. In the Renderer drop-down menu, choose the Art Renderer. In the Art Renderer tab, there are two main controls. One is Render Quality, and the other is Noise Filtering. There are a few other controls, but these two are the main controls to focus on right now. Now we're going to add a few lights. The scene has so many objects, it's hard to see where to put the lights. So in the main toolbar, click on the Selection Set drop-down menu. Choose Simplified Scene from the list. Then right-click in the viewport and choose Isolate Selection. Now, in the Create panel, select Lights, then choose Photometric Lights, Target Light. The Photometric Light Creation dialog pops up. It recommends the Physical Camera Exposure Control, giving us different controls such as Exposure Value that helps brighten or darken the whole scene. Click Yes to continue. In the left viewport, drag from inside the flared housing of the lamp down to the wall just above the seat to create the photometric target light. In the Scene Explorer, select both the light and target using Control click. Then, in the top viewport, move it so it is aligned with the lamp closest to the train, which is the Lamp 002 object. In the camera viewport, hold Shift and move to the left to copy the light and its target and line it up with Lamp 001. Choose Instance from the Clone Options dialog, which means both lights can be controlled together as one. Click OK. Right-click in the viewport and choose from the Quad menu, End Isolate. And then render the camera viewport. The light looks great on the wall, but the overall scene is too dark because the scene needs more light. Instead of adding another light object, we are going to turn mesh objects into lights. To do this, we start in the Slate Material Editor. Drag a physical material into the view. Double-click on the node title to load the properties and rename Light Glass New. In the basic parameters, change the base color to black. Then go to the Emissions section and turn the amount to 1. The emission component will turn any object it's applied to into a light emitting surface. In the main toolbar, the Selection Set drop-down menu and choose Ceiling Lights. Then in the Slate Material Editor, apply Light Glass New to those 3 ceiling objects. Now render the physical camera viewport. On the left is the image rendered before the light emissive material was applied, and on the right is the rendered scene after. There's quite a difference. Notice the soft nature of light coming from the large ceiling lights above. thanks to the advanced features of the Art Renderer. It's very natural. In the background of the scene, it's pure black. This really doesn't work if we're trying to render a daylight scene. Now that we are using a physically based render, it allows for indirect light. We can use the sun positioner and the physical sky to define an environment that has illumination and then insert an image to act as a background. Now zoom out of the left view so you can see the height of the station. Also, zoom out in the top view to see the whole station. The sun positioner simulates sunlight using geographically correct angles and the movement of the sun. Go to the Create panel, select Lights, and then select the sun positioner. In the top viewport, to the left of the train station, click and drag to create the compass. Don't worry about its size. Release the mouse, then move the mouse, rotate the compass until the N is pointing up in the scene. Watching the left view, move the mouse so that this part of the sun positioner is above the station's roof. Right-click to release from the sun positioner. Go into the Modify panel with the sun positioner still selected to see its options. You can choose location, date, time, and compass orientation to orient the light. Let's leave it as is for now, but feel free to adjust it as you like. Go into the Rendering, Environment, and Effects panel. When you create a sun positioner, a physical sun and sky environment is automatically added to the environment map, which is basically a sky texture that surrounds the scene. This inserts more indirect light in the scene, so we'll need to control how much we capture using exposure control. First, turn off the Use Physical Camera Controls If Available checkbox. You would want that only if you were working with the advanced camera features, which we are not. Go down to the Exposure Control, and in the Global Exposure, the default exposure value is 6 EV, which will be too bright when rendered, so change it to 12 EV. Now, render the physical camera viewport. In the render, you can see the background has a bright sky and a horizon, though it looks plain and empty. In the Scene Explorer, unhide Image Plane Layer. This turns on a plane mapped with a background image, as you can see here. Then reduce the exposure value to 11. Render the camera viewport again. The background looks good reflecting on the train and was surprisingly easy to set up as a photo mapped on a plane. Open the Render Setup dialog and in the Common tab, in Output Size drop-down menu, change to HD TV Video. Then in the Width value, enter 960. The height automatically changes to 540 to maintain the image aspect ratio. This is half high definition resolution. Render the camera view and note how long it takes to render on your machine. This frame took about 1 minute and 50 seconds. We'd like to render the entire frame animation, which means this can take over 3 hours on a single machine, which quite honestly is perfectly normal in production. even for a draft quality render that we have here. But if you need a faster render for the animation, go to the Art Renderer tab and reduce the render target quality value from 20 down to 15. Even with a small drop in quality, this render comes in at about 40 seconds, though it does have quite a bit more noise. Depending on how much time you have, you can experiment to find the right quality to output. Higher quality, cleaner renders will take more time. And again, that is perfectly normal. Just don't forget to account for rendering time in your projects. Leave quality at 15 for now. Let's see how to render the sequence. In the Common tab, under Time Output, select Active Time Segment. Go down to the Render Output section. Select the Files button. Name the file Render Final. And from the Save As type, choose JPEG File. Click Save, and then OK the Image Control dialog. Now you are ready to launch your render, which can take an hour and a half or more. When you are ready, click the Render button. Now you're free to grab a coffee and relax. Your part of the job is done for now. While you can render directly to a video file like an AVI or QuickTime movie, it is recommended to render an image sequence and then compile it to a video file. The benefit of using an image sequence instead is twofold. One, you have better quality options for how the image is compressed. Two, it's safer because if a render fails, like your cat walks across your keyboard, you can pick up where you stopped with an image sequence, but not with a movie file. While you can use your machine while you render, it will run much slower. When rendering is finished, go to the Render menu and choose Compare Media in RAM Player. Select Open Channel A icon and load the image sequence. First thing you get is the Image File List Control dialog. OK this, and then the RAM Player Configuration dialog pops up. This will give you basic information about the image sequence, such as size and how many frames. OK this dialog also. Once the sequence is loaded, you can use the player to view the sequence. If you care to share this with your social media circle, simply compile the sequence into a video file using an edit app such as iMovie. Or if none is available to you, you may have to render directly to a video file as opposed to a JPEG sequence as we did here. And remember, don't let your cat near the keyboard.